Welcome to ChemHelp ASAP. Let's do an example where we convert a line angle structure to a structure of Lewis dot notation. Okay, we have on the screen a molecule. This is a known drug, acetaminophen. Outside the United States, I think most countries, they refer to this as paracetamol. But we've shown it in the line angle structure. So how do we convert this to a Lewis dot structure? And this is an important skill because line angle structures leave out a lot of details, and it's important that you're able to fill those details back in. So let's number our atoms, particularly in this ring. And then we'll number these additional two carbons. And there are few enough of nitrogens and oxygens, we can fill those in later. So let's start with our ring. A six-membered ring of carbon atoms. Remember, each of those vertices, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, those represent carbon atoms. So let's number these on the inside. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. There's our six-membered ring. Carbon 1 and 2 have two bonds between them. So let's add that. Same is true for 3 and 4 and 5 and 6. And now, what's going on with carbon 2? Well, carbon 2 only has three bonds shown. It needs to have four bonds, so that unwritten fourth bond must be a bond to a hydrogen. Carbon 3 is the exact same. It is shown with three bonds. It needs a fourth bond, and that's to a hydrogen. Carbon 4 has four bonds over in the Lewis structure. The fourth bond is to oxygen. So let's draw that in. That's to our oxygen. And our oxygen also has a hydrogen. We're going to draw that with a full bond, not just draw that to the side, but a full bond. Now, oxygen is only shown with four valence electrons. We have two bonds. It's only four electrons. We need four more. Those are going to come in the form of lone pairs. Great, let's continue around the ring. Carbon 5 is just like number 2 and number 3. It has three bonds. We need a fourth, and that's to an unshown hydrogen. And the same is for 6. So for the Lewis structure, we have to show these hydrogens. Now, carbon 1 is attached to a nitrogen, and that completes carbon 1. That gives it its four bonds. Nitrogen has a bond to a hydrogen, so show that out as a proper long bond. The nitrogen is also attached to carbon 7, which is in turn attached to carbon 8. Let's number those, 7 and 8. And let's give them C's. I forgot to give them C's. So carbon 7 has two bonds to an oxygen. That completes all four bonds to that carbon. And carbon 8 only has one bond shown to it in the line angle structure. So it must have three other bonds. Those are two hydrogens. So let's draw them in. Now, we haven't finished our oxygen or our nitrogen. This oxygen at the top of the screen in our Lewis structure only has four valence electrons with those two bonds. It needs four more as two lone pairs to complete its octet. And the nitrogen we haven't completed. It's shown in our current Lewis structure with only three bonds. It needs to have a full valence, so we'll give it one lone pair to complete its valence. And that is the full Lewis dot structure for acetaminophen. Again, this is an important skill. It's great to leave out details and draw these quick and simple line angle structures, but in our minds, we need to be able to fill in those details. How many hydrogens are on that atom? How many lone pairs does that atom have? And so practicing these kinds of problems will help you just intuitively understand what are the features on each of your atoms.